Deal with Jeff Sneider.
What's the deal with Thanksgiving? If you're watching this video, I'm back in Boston freezing my ass off and more grateful than ever for the countless hours of entertainment that Hollywood has provided me with this year. So in the spirit of giving thanks, here are the movies and TV shows that I'm grateful for this year. For starters, I'm grateful for Roger Ebert, not just for inspiring me to review movies, which led to my current line of work, but for having the courage to allow Steve James to film the last few months of his life. Life itself was an incredible story of strength and hope, and I encourage all of you to see it. I'm thankful for the great comedies and genre films that came out this year. Films like Neighbors, 22 Jump Street, The Guest, Cheap Thrills, and The Raid 2. Those don't get mentioned nearly enough in year-end wrap-ups, but those films succeeded in either making me laugh or keeping me on the edge of my seat. I'm thankful for fresh faces like Jack O'Connell, who lit up the screen and starred up in 71, the guest duo of Dan Stevens and Micah Monroe, as well as Jaden Lieberer, who delivered one of the best child performances I've seen in years in St. Vincent. I'm also thankful for the actors who continue to push themselves to new heights, such as Jake Gyllenhaal in Nightcrawler, Michael Keaton in Birdman, Miles Teller in Whiplash, and Channing Tatum in Foxcatcher. I'm grateful for dreamers like Darren Aronofsky and Stephen Knight, who went big with Noah and small with Locke, respectively, each hitting it out of the park. I'm grateful that audiences rejected lousy blockbusters like The Amazing Spider-Man 2 and Transcendence, which got the fates they deserved. I'm grateful for all the nudity in Gone Girl, from Emily Ratajkowski's breasts to Ben Affleck's penis, which led to some incredible think pieces online. I'm thankful for former publicists like Ava DuVernay and Justin Simien, who reinvented themselves as filmmakers with something to say. And I expect that they'll both be vital voices in Hollywood for years to come. I'm thankful to the Sundance Film Festival and its Press Express Pass, which is a lifesaver for a guy with a job like mine. I'm thankful for Kevin Smith's perverse sense of humor, Keanu Reeves' comeback, and the fact that Luke Greenfield got to direct another one of his own scripts, as well as the fact that someone had the good sense to bring Eric Bogosian's novel Maul to the big screen. I'm thankful for Ryan Murphy, not because of Glee or American Horror Story, but because of The Normal Heart on HBO, which just was a really moving story that I thought, you know, was important to tell. Speaking of HBO, I'm grateful for True Detective, the tech nerds on Silicon Valley, and for John Oliver, who was just fantastic this year. Speaking of television, I'm thankful for The Goldbergs, Key and Peele, all my favorite shows. You know, I'm thankful that even though Dexter Morgan didn't get the ending that he deserved, Hank Moody kind of did. I'm thankful Ray Donovan made the sophomore leap and that the entire Special Victims Unit keeps churning out goodness on a weekly basis. I'm thankful SNL came to its senses and hired not one but two women of color and that Lorne reunited the Good Neighbor Gang in full. Speaking of SNL, I'm thankful for Bill Murray, because everyone should always be thankful for Bill Murray, who I met this year at the Toronto International Film Festival. I'm also thankful that David Spade dropped a new comedy album. While we're talking comedy, I'm thankful that Crackle has given Jerry Seinfeld the space to be himself on Comedians in Cars. I'm thankful that weirdo writers like David Wayne and Michael Showalter are still going strong. And I'm thankful that Shia is still Shia. I'm thankful for Robin Williams and the infinite hours of entertainment he provided me with over my 30 years on this planet. I'm thankful for Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, and the entire Schmoes Know team, who I started out beefing with before we patched things up, and now they gave me my own podcast, which I co-host on Fridays with the great Mark Riley. I'm grateful that my co-workers at TheWrap put up with my crap as much as I do, and I'm thankful for all the hard work that they do, as well as all the great articles that I've read this year, you know, on other sites, from our rival trades, to the Oscar blogs, to Grantland. I'm thankful for my friends, my family, and of course, my sources, without whom I'd be nothing. So, thank you, Hollywood, and have a happy Thanksgiving. This has been What's the Deal with Jeff Sneider. You can follow me on Twitter at TheInSneider, and thanks for reading TheWrap.com.
What's the deal with Jeff Sneider?